Okay, Captain Mars, the camera's on.
Yes, yes.
We will both.
First of all, to the subscribers and viewers, thanks for the support, for visiting our channel, for all your comments, for your subscriptions, and for sharing and spreading the passion for the RC planes from this channel to the rest of the world, Captain Blasi.
Hey, look at this, eh?
Yeah, of course, November, eh? You will be like a Santa Claus, eh, this year, eh?
Yes.
Do you know how do you look, eh? Like a buck naked, eh?
What?
Like a buck naked.
Oh, yeah.
Like George Costanza, eh? The poor actor, eh?
Yeah.
From some old
German... Hey, we are not...
From some old German movies, but hey, friends. Yeah. Enough, because I said that we will make shorter videos, and I will get to the point right now. Of course, thanks for your support.
Hey, look at this.
For every
sexy reflection.
Sharing of this, our videos, and of course for being our friends. Now the point is, of course, I will just say this. Maybe somebody will just come today on this channel, see the video for the first time. This is the channel where we have dedicated our free time to film RC planes.
Do you know what this is?
And without editing.
You know what this is? Amateur hour, eh?
Yeah, of course. Because on this channel we never pretend to be professionals, because we are not, eh? We're just two enthusiasts, brothers, amateurs, that will try to test as many different planes as possible, my friends, eh? Whatever plane we can get our hands on, we will test it on our runway, and we will tell the truth, and that's the point, because we never lie. It would be simple that I tried this plane 2-3 times before, and then we film the flight review video when I know all about this plane and there will be no surprises. But why? Why? We must film the maiden flight, because right now I still don't know what will happen. Do you know? I don't think so, eh?
No.
Will this be the maiden flight or the crash? Well, who the hell knows if we don't try. What's with your Captain Black all the time?
What did the moles came rain? From, eh?
What?
Yeah, moles.
Yeah, of course, the moles came back, since now we have some crazy rain every day, and the ground is now soft, and now they can stuck their noses inside and make these piles on which we break the wheels, eh? But the good thing is that today we don't have the wheels. Today we have the beautiful and sexy brand new release, the refreshed V2 Avios Albatros, eh?
From Hobby King.
From Hobby King, of course. You have the link below, so check it quick. Don't wait, nothing, eh? If you have missed the first one, don't be too late on this one also, eh?
Yes.
Now, of course, 1.6 meter wingspan, double the motors, that runs on 4-cell. You also can set yourself here the differential thrust.
Yes.
And the, it does have the reverse.
Thrust.
Thrust, yeah.
Thrust.
If you are flying this from the river and you get stuck in the bush, you have the reverse. Also, like in the bedroom, sometimes you have to reverse if you're stuck in the bush. Eh? Of course. I mean, hey, yeah, hey, you can get stuck in the bush on many occasions. Eh?
Well, not me.
Usually,
eh?
On the rivers, you always get stuck in the bush with these planes, yes, and it has the reverse for that. Of course, little jokes on this channel, because flying RC planes, my friends, say, don't be wrong. This is not life and death situation. This is meant to be fun. And we are not doing this for our living. So that means that we can joke a little on this channel. A few words about the assembly, of course, like always. Now, I will just tell you this, say, that this plane, in fact, is meant to be flown on the river. Of course, I have taken away the rudder in the back because I don't need it. We will test this today on our grass, in fact, on our magic carpet. But still, the plane is wet today.
Yes, because
if
it's sitting...
If we don't have the wet river, we still, at least we have the wet table here.
And it is sitting in the puddle.
Yes, and I'm already wet around my nose in my mustaches, because I want to have the beautiful maiden flight with this. Now, of course, this is the plane that I already have in the past. A few words about the assembly. The assembly was no surprise, my friends. The plane fits together perfectly. Just one thing that I will tell you. When you will put together the wings, the tip of the wings, because in fact, if I will show you this, of course, if you have this plane, you know that you have here two screws, and you can take away the tips of the wings, and then you have the plane that you can go to the runway even on your monocycle or something like that.
Yes, unicycle.
Now, of course, when you will put this together, you have a small carbon, I don't know if that's carbon or something, it has to be, but it's not black. That little spar that holds the wings. Now, in the middle of that spar, it does have a little tooth, so you don't push it too much in the wing, in one wing and the other. But in fact, that tooth, eh, will make a little gap between the wings. And when you will put the wings together, if you will set one screw to see directly in the fret, the other one will be half of the fret way. Uh-huh. And that was, I was struggling with that one, even on the first one, on the first version, I have ruined the screws, the frets inside, because I just couldn't get the screw inside. So this time what I have discovered, you have the two, I think that aluminum tubes that goes in the wings.
Yeah.
So on one tube, just grind around millimeter of the material, so the carbon bar will go inside in the wing a little more, around millimeter,
uh-huh.
and then the wings will fit perfect together, oh. and you will not thinking why the hell this screw doesn't go inside of the wings.
Eh? Very good.
Of
yes.
course, 1.6 meter, like I have said, double the motor, and it also has the navigational landing lights, and I will show you that I have found the CG, according to the book, 67 millimeters. I have went it from the leading edge of the wing, and with a 4000 milliamp battery at this position, it gives me the kind of perfect
G-spot. Eh?
Now, one thing that I recommend is change the Velcro inside, I mean the strap inside, for the graphene 200 millimeter one. I mean, I just love this strap, say, for the batteries. You can really tie the battery good. Of course, this is the maiden flight. I won't do many stunts, so one strap is enough. For the second flight, when we will do the flight review, maybe some rolls, I will put the second one here. Eh?
Yes.
Captain lost so many informations, and I said that I will be quick, and I wanted to say something more, but that's enough, eh?
Say something for the later, eh?
I will just show you something, Captain Blush, that don't...
What?
Many people don't know this, eh?
What?
Yeah.
Maybe the other one?
No, it's interesting, maybe at the end of the flight I will show you. I can just tell you that in fact here, if you are not watching the steward's video, Captain Blush, it was not on the first one. This piece of the foam is held in by the magnets, and if you pull it out, it has four magnets, you can get to the ESC inside and everything. I mean, this is unbelievable.
Hey, yeah, try. Really, Captain, try it open now.
Yeah, I can't.
Yeah, why not?
Yeah, I can't get my fingers inside here, but you can see.
I have crooked fingers.
No, don't. I will do this at home. I have forgotten. No, leave it, Captain Blush. But it is, you can see here, the cut all around, and if you grab it from this side, you can open it, do you see?
Maybe you can put some duct tape inside.
Yeah, of course, I will open it at home, I have forgot this. And I will put some little duct tape, and then you can hold it and push it. But in fact, for the flight, this is totally unnecessary.
Yes.
Turn the radio on, I have set this to 5 minutes. Of course, it does have also, it comes with the flaps, but it doesn't have the landing gear. Now that means, like I have said, that this is meant for the water, but still you can also fly this
out from the
from
snow,
the grass,
grass.
I don't know what.
Yes.
Even from the asphalt, if you make
something that is something that, something that has a slidable surface.
That's it. Of course, I have put it myself the throttle cut on this.
What receiver are you using? Antennaless?
Antennaless spectrum receiver. And the first time I had, now, if you will check the first flights, you have seen that I have got, yeah, of course. Of
the
course.
First flight is mine, eh?
One thing that I can tell you right now about this plane is that don't go too slow in the turns, eh? If you will go too slow, you will tip stall. Captain Blush, you have tip stalled this plane on the River Krka. River Sava, we had the crazy wind. I mean, that was the best crash ever, but we got the plane out. Check that video, I mean, that was epic. It was nothing wrong with the plane. Pilot mistake, Captain
yeah,
Blush,
well,
admit, eh?
Yeah, but of course it was my mistake. And you have tested it 2 days later
on the River
Krka. On the River
Krka,
and it is.
Flight.
And a few times here on the runway.
A few times here on the runway, but then I had the problem, say. I had the signal loss one, I have crashed the plane on the second time. First time I had the signal loss because I was using the orange receiver, but it's not the point in the orange receiver. I have discovered that I had the problems with those receivers only then when the antenna was behind the battery. And that's it, eh? Even one guy told me that, of course, I will salute you, but I knew that and I have discovered that on my own also, eh? The second time that I have crashed, I have also was too slow in the turn. I have tip stall. The third flight was great on the V1 version, but then I have changed the props with the master air screw once, but in fact, those are not so good as this one because they did unscrew to myself. One prop unscrewed, and if that will happen, you will have the differential thrust. You will not know what's happening in the air and you will crash your plane. That means, leave the plane as it is, set it to the manual,
Didn't you came here to see the flight or?
I don't know, hey.
We're just postponing.
Yeah, but
again.
I really want to make short stuff. Of course, that means if I was talking now, I won't talk too much at the end, eh?
Yeah, you wish.
But of course, today I will try the travels here on the table. Runs! Right, left, up, down, left, right. I also have the mix ailerons to rudder. Just in case in the turns. If you had this option on the radio, set it so you don't have to think later.
Throttle.
And of course, throttle cut off. And let's try.
Ooh.
And that's it, eh?
That's it. Saved
that's
juice.
That's it.
Ooh, what's this?
I will put the mix off. Of course, we didn't test the flaps. Two positions. I have no... I have no mixing with the elevator because... I don't know, throttle cut on again. And now you can grab the plane here. Because I can't remember if this baby even needs some.
I don't think so, because on one flight you had...
Whatever I want.
You had glued flaps, if you remember. On the first version.
The first crash,
Yeah.
Hey, on the first plane we don't even have the flaps.
No.
We didn't even test them.
Because,
so I will test them.
Because we have broke the servos.
Oh, of course, in the crash in the river, eh? Yeah, this will be it, my friend, say. Of course.
Enough.
Wet grass will help you even more.
Now, good luck.
But also this carpet is very wet. Wish me good luck, Captain Blush, and that's it, eh?
Watch out for the geese, eh?
Oh, look at this, eh?
Flock of birds, eh?
I hope I won't hit them, eh? Should I put some flaps? I will put nothing, eh? Just remind me, Captain Blush.
What?
To keep the speed in turn, say.
Yes.
Because on the last flights I have forgotten that this plane does need some speed. Otherwise, like I have said, I will tip stall it. So this is it. The manual flight with Albatross version 2. The Coast Guard scheme, eh?
Yes.
A lot of differences, small details, but you can check them in the description, eh?
Yes.
Oh yeah. Little trimming. I put battery even more
to the front, huh?
To the front, yeah. I have even the carpet. I have took off the carpet, did you see?
Yes, it has rolled back. I'll show it later in the camera.
This is unbelievable. You see it good?
Of course.
Of course, speed in the turns and then slow down. Don't take off too much power in the turns. Oh, it flies so good.
It's so sexy in the air.
Hey, but it's so easy to handle, my friend. This is sick, eh? Of course, once from the other side. Low and sexy for the pleasure. It behaves so good that this is unbelievable.
Does it?
Hey, so good. A little help of the rudder in the turns. Do you see it good now? I will do a little circle around you. Are you zooming?
Yes.
You can see it good. Speed in the turn. Then you can reduce, come low. Now I will come one full speed from that side. Are you ready?
Yes.
Let's check this. This will be now the full speed pass.
Oh.
Huh?
Pretty fast.
Pretty good, huh?
Uh-huh. Well, the sound of two engines is...
Let's see, up. Look. 2 minutes left. Uh-huh, we said that we will...
Try the flaps.
Try the flaps. Go back. Don't want to hit that bird. Now we deploy them and I will come out of the turn. These are now the full flaps.
Oh. It didn't balloon. Or did?
Oh, look at this, eh? Pretty sexy, huh?
Yes.
Flaps up. Of course, I think that I will use, you know what?
What?
Time remaining, 1 minute.
I think that I will slowly prepare for the landing the next time, because this is the last flyby in all its glory for the viewers. And now I will land with just the takeoff flaps.
Uh-huh.
I will deploy. I have now the landing flaps.
Hey, you have hit the hot carpet, eh? Hey, this was one of your best maiden flights, eh?
Hey, do you know what I have realized, eh?
What?
If I want to land good, I need the river flying planes to do that, eh?
Hey, look what you did on the takeoff, eh?
See the power there, eh? The power is so tremendous that even the carpet rolled together, eh? Yeah, but really, you will see on the beginning of the video. Uh-huh, wait.
What? Throttle cut?
Yeah, don't reach your fingers, my friend, say. Will you go for the plane?
I can grab the plane, of course.
There.
Yes.
Throttle cut on, don't worry, Captain Blush.
Flaps, hey, flaps up, flaps up. Yes.
But this was unbelievable, eh? Ah, tell me.
Yes. It was even very friendly for the camera, you know?
And maybe this fog, but the plane is white.
Hey, it has blurred. It has blurred only once.
It's interesting.
And the blurring was because of your head, because I was filming through, yeah.
And so that means that the fog, I mean, this is the low cloudness, or how do you call this, is in fact...
Yeah.
Is in fact even better than like this. And now you can put the camera back.
Uh-huh, okay.
You have here the checker, because I was flying this for 5 minutes almost. And let's check for
go
the
in
reference.
Front. You go in front.
Because in fact you will take out the battery or what?
Yes.
Uh-huh. Because in fact I wasn't flying this plane before on the 4-cell battery. I mean on the 4000 milliamp. And what I will tell you about the CG. Check
The battery is cold as a stone.
Check the position of the battery as it was in my plane and put it 2 centimeters more to the front.
Or 1 inch. Almost
because
1 inch.
In fact, it was still...
Oh.
What? Tell me.
What was your... Were you flying fast all the time?
Yeah, I wasn't. But
yeah, you can leave it like this then.
Leave it?
What? 56%.
Yeah, 56, Captain Blush.
Yeah, but if you will fly full speed, yeah, that's it, no?
Yeah, but I don't think that I will fly. Okay, I will
leave it like this.
The next time I can turn off the radio,
but of course. The battery is stone cold, eh?
Yeah, this, of course it is, eh? Because this is amazing plane. And Captain Blush, show with what I was flying, eh? I'm loving this radio more and more. Not that, the radio, Captain Blush, eh?
Uh-huh.
Because I just love this NX10 radio, eh?
Uh-huh.
Of course, I will grab the plane once in my hands, Captain Blasche, grab the camera. Just so later I can, you know what?
Yes, I know.
I can make myself
thumbnail.
A beautiful thumbnail.
Wait.
So you can get me in the camera.
Few seconds.
Okay.
Few seconds like this. Okay.
I come closer.
No.
I come far away.
Like this, yes.
Like this?
Yeah, like this.
In all directions.
Like this.
So later I can I can cut something out from the
video.
Do
you know what I wonder? If I tilt the camera like this.
Yeah, what?
If it will tilt it in the video, I don't think so, eh?
Yeah, of course not. I leave it. Viewers will get sick, eh? What's with you, Captain Blasche? Aha, of course. For the closure of the video, I will put it like this, eh? Yeah. So we can really see it good. Do you see the whole plane?
Yeah, no.
What is missing?
A bit of the tail. Like this, yes.
Like this?
Yeah.
A few words, my friends, this is it, eh? Like I have thought, eh? Don't wait too long. Click quick on the link below. Don't miss this one. Because
the snow is coming and you can fly this in the snow.
You can fly from the snow. Now this was the proof that you don't even need the river. You can fly from snow, you can fly from grass, from whatever you want. And I will tell you now the assessment of this. I mean, I will give this plane 9.5 without any problems right now, eh?
Yeah,
because to tell you the truth, eh, the feeling in fact was, I don't know, 100 times better than on the first version one. I don't know why. But today I felt such confidence that this is unbelievable. And it was so easy.
Well, the first version was a bitter taste because I have crashed it on the maiden flight. And ever since then, you had that taste in your, you know, in
your
feeling.
Yeah, of course it was. And of course, you know, my friends, sometimes when you crash the plane, later they fly even better. But with that plane, it was not that occasion. I mean, it was flying good, but to get those informations, it needed to crash a few times. So now I can really tell you how to set this plane good. Set it to the manual and the CG is perfect, eh?
Yes.
You can even go with the less CG, the lower one. Go with the 65, it will be much better. I have now the 67. It still looks like it will go to the nose. So check my battery. It is crucial because after I took off, the plane really went up. I could have put that battery even 20 millimeters more to the front that I was using. And it will give you 5 minutes of beautiful flying time. And this is really one quality. And I'm really happy that this plane came out again. Eh? Now, yes. If this plane, if Avios is listening, if you will release this plane in the third time, you can do it. But on the third time, put the wheels on, it can be done. I know that the Seawind plane has beautiful retractable landing gears that hide inside. Can you imagine the plane that this baby has, the retractable landing gear? It will cost more, but then this would be a winner, eh? And of course, on the wings, what you should do for the version 3, put the quick connectors in, eh? You have the quick connectors on so many planes, say,
like almost, SkySort.
Yeah, SkySort and all of them. But here you have to screw with those connectors, eh? Put the quick connectors in and that's it, eh? But still, I will give this plane 9.5 because it is worth to have it. It is flying great and you will love it. You can control it good and today I was really feeling good. Just don't forget, like I have said, have speed in the turns and you will be one happy pilot all over again. And of course, with the planes like this that have the foam hinges, don't forget, if you will fly a lot, check them from time to time. They can break on every plane that has the foam hinges. Reinforce them little before that, or you can reinforce them even, do you know what, with what, Captain Blasche, I have seen?
Duct tape.
You can put the hot glue in,
uh-huh.
Quickly remove it, yeah. But when it will dry, it will make a little cover of the glue and it will not break. It's interesting.
No.
Hot glue. And just remove it quick. It will stay a little film of that glue.
Now look at me, look at the camera.
Look at the camera, of course.
Yeah.
So this is it.
Yes.
Enough Captain Blasche for today.
Tomorrow another flight.
I'm preparing more planes, of course, and Captain Blasche also for the next time. This was this test, of course. Like I have said on this channel, we never pretend to be professionals, we're just having good time here. And of course, on every video, we do try to give you good informations, and that is because of you. So you will be one happy pilot that will fly and fly all over again and not crash the plane on the first flight. But if you will crash, don't get discouraged. Crash will happen no matter how good you are. crashes will happen, eh? The only thing on our channel is that you see crash from time to time is that we show them, eh? We don't hide them, eh? We could easily not post the crashes and you would think, hey, oh my god, they're filming for 5 years now and they haven't crashed a single plane. Of course we have, eh? And we show it all, eh? And that's the point. Pilot Robert and Captain Blas signing off from Slovenia with beautiful and sexy Avios Albatros Coast Guard scheme, the Transon 4 cell, 1.6 meter wingspan, double the motor, triple the fun. Don't wait too long, click quick, my friend, say, and that's it, and have fun. Who knows what will happen tomorrow, so you must have fun today. And I will just tell you one thing, of course, later, of course, if I will not fly, since I'm having problem where to stuck my planes, of course, this will not be my everyday plane. It will be for the winter or something, I don't know, because when we have tall grass here, I use the planes with the wheels, but still, in the meantime, I will be able to put it back in the box because I have the problem with the storage. I don't have room anymore. Now, what I have done, I have assembled the plane, but I didn't use the glue in the back. That's the point that I'm trying to say, Captain Blas, to the viewers. You don't necessarily need to glue the plane, the back of the plane, because now I just
unscrew the screws,
disassemble the plane, and I can put it in box in the same way that it came. And next year I can assemble it again. But if I glue the back of the plane, yeah, that's it, eh? I can't stuck it anymore in the box, eh? This is just one tip, and it's still, this is so strong, don't worry, it won't fall off, eh? Because it has four bolts, so that's it, eh? Now, Captain Blas, quick! Because I will enjoy this flight, eh?
Yes.
I really feel good after such a long time. I was flying again, and I have forgot how thrilling the maiden flight is. For me, the maiden flight is as thrilling as the unboxing of the plane that I haven't seen before. Eh? So this is it, viewers. We love you all.
See you very soon.
See you soon, eh? Okay, Captain Blas. As long as I will see the red light, I will talk on this channel. And I said, you're just postponing, Captain Blas. That's what you say to me. Of course, you can salute our dear friends all around the world, eh?
Yes. That's it?
Of course, Captain Blas. Good enough, eh?